Hello everyone, and welcome to an official Clip Studio Paint tutorial video. In this tutorial, we'll show you how to draw with traditional ink and watercolor style brushes. Try different brush combinations and express your personal style on the canvas. First, let's create a canvas to draw on. Tap New from the command bar. Then set project to illustration and enter 2000 for both the width and height. Now tap OK in the upper right corner to create a square canvas. Layers are used in digital drawing. A layer is like a transparent piece of film. By using layers, you can manage each step of your workflow in case you want to make changes later. Press the icon on the left side of the screen to open the layer palette. For today's illustration, we'll divide the layers by the type of brush. Tap New Raster Layer on the top of the layer palette to add a layer. Name each of the layers after the brush type. Double tap the layer name to rename it. The layer order from top to bottom is ink, watercolor, and pencil. You can reorder layers by long pressing the grip on the right side of each one and dragging. For sketching, we'll use the pencil tool. In the layer palette, select the pencil layer we made earlier. Now let's choose our brush. Select the pencil tool from the tool palette. Then select the pencil sub tool from the sub tool palette. You can change the color of the pencil by tapping the black tile in the color set palette, where basic colors are registered. You can draw the sneaker as it is, but I'll tilt it on its heel to create a dynamic composition. After drawing a rough silhouette, draw in the details. If you make a mistake, use the eraser tool. Select the eraser icon to use it and erase as needed. Once the shape is defined enough to be a base for the line art, the sketch is complete. Now let's make the sketch lines a little lighter. Open the layer palette and shift the opacity slider in the upper right to the left. Now we can still faintly see the sketch while drawing the line art. We'll draw the line art with a brush that looks like ink. In the layer palette, select the ink layer. Tap the brush tool in the tool palette, then choose the brush pen from the India Ink tab. Let's draw in black again, like with the pencil. The thickness and roughness of the brush pen depends on your pen pressure and speed. Intentionally vary your pen pressure to create dynamic lines. By setting a large brush size in the brush size palette, you can get a more varied effect. It is easier to control your brush strokes if you rotate the canvas as needed. With two fingers, tap and drag to rotate and adjust the angle of the canvas. The line thickness and tapering can create a three-dimensional effect. When you want to redraw a line, use Undo. Tap with two fingers on the canvas to undo the last line drawn. Use the brush pen to draw overlapping shoelaces and the shadows. The line art is now complete. When you've finished the line art, go to the layer palette and remove the pencil layer. Tap the eye icon to the left of the layer name to hide it. If you want to add more detail to express the texture and depth, add hatching with a pen tool. Hatching is a technique that expresses shadow and texture by adding diagonal lines to areas that you want to appear darker. Tap the pen tool in the tool palette, then choose the mapping pen from the pen tab. The mapping pen is good for fine details. Add hatching to areas where shadows cast or overlap. By changing the density of the diagonal lines or overlapping them so that they intersect, you can create different levels of shadow. You can also create other moods with different pens. Try the hatching technique with different types of pen and different line thicknesses to match what you want to draw. Next, let's move on to the colors. Select the watercolor layer in the layer palette. With a watercolor brush, we'll apply two colors on top of each other. I decided to use two colors, bright orange and deep green, for this drawing. Let's select our orange color from the color wheel palette. Tap the brush tool in the tool palette, then choose the watercolor splash subtool from the watercolor tab. Watercolor splash creates an effect like splattering wet paint from a brush. It includes slight color jitter, so a range of colors appear. Set the brush size to 700 in the brush size palette. Paint the orange color along the top of the canvas. Next, let's select our deep green color from the color wheel palette. As before, paint the green color on the bottom half of the canvas. Let's make it so the orange and green mix under the drawing of the sneaker. Next, let's adjust the depth of the colors. On the sub-tool palette, select Wet Wash. Wet Wash creates strokes like those from a very wet brush. You can paint with transparency with Wet Wash to lighten the colors on the canvas, as if diluting them with water. While controlling the pin pressure, erase some color on the laces and upper part of the sneaker. After adjusting the darkness, let's add more color with Wet Wash. We'll paint in more color with the same orange and green that we used before. Open the Color History palette to reselect a color you have previously used. Your recently used colors are shown here. Let's paint the sole with the deep green. Adjust the brush size as you paint. With Wet Wash, the color deepens as you layer it up. When you want to paint an area evenly, paint the area at once without lifting the pen. For the shoelaces, let's paint with orange. Next, reduce the brush size and switch to transparent color. Then carefully erase in the pattern of the shoe stitching. And now the color is finished! Finally, add one layer at the top called Signature. Select the brush pen in white and set the brush size to 50. Add your signature to complete the artwork.
Clip Studio Paint.